Welcome now to subnetting 14. This is video number 14. We're going to begin to develop a chart that we can use later. And at first you may not understand why I'm doing what I'm doing, but again, hold on when we start doing practical problems using this chart. It's all going to come together and you're going to say, oh, that's so easy. This is the basic chart we've seen so far. Let's assume that we're in the fourth octet here. So my subnet mask here looks like 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and so on. The three sets of ones. And these are the values that we've seen before. If we were going to convert the fourth octet to decimal values, we would use these numbers. Now, don't worry about this blue, this one being blue here. The reason it's blue is because I'm going to talk about borrowing a bit here. So at the beginning here, let's just assume they're all the same color, and that any I could make any value by just putting ones where they belong here in my IP address, right? But if I borrow one bit, then this particular bit here, or this value out of my IP address, becomes part of the network address. And now I only have these numbers left that I can use for hosts. Well, if I put 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, in other words, all ones for all of my host bits, what would I come up to? Well, 64 plus 32 plus 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1 would bring us to 127. So in other words, just short of this, there are 128 possible values. This could bring us up to as far as 127. Now, I'm going to begin adding some things to this, because remember, if I'm borrowing a bit here, if I'm borrowing a bit, I can get two networks now. I can get all of the numbers. If this is a 0, I can get 1 to 64 and go 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. And then if this is a 1 here, then I can go 1 through 64, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So I can get two different possible networks out of this. Let's take a look at what this looks like. I could get two networks if I borrow one bit. I could get four subnets or networks if I borrow two bits. I could get 8 if I borrow three bits. 16, 32, 64, 128, 256. I can't actually use these, as we'll see later on, or as you actually saw in the last video, because I don't have enough hosts left. But at any rate, this is the sequence of how many subnets you can get by borrowing X number of bits. If I borrow one bit, I can get two. If I borrow two bits, I can get four. Three bits, I can get eight, and so on. Underneath this, I'm going to put the subnet masks. Now, remember, this subnet mask is 255.255.255, and I have another one here, so .128, right? It would look like this, 255, 255, 255, 128. If I borrowed another bit and put one here, I could get four networks, and my subnet mask would be 255, 255, 255, 192. 224, if I put a subnet mask one over here, 240, 248, 252, 254, 255. We've seen this before. I'm assuming 255, 255, 255, and we're all working in the fourth octet here. One more thing I'm going to add to this, and that is the CIDR notation. Now, remember that CIDR notation for 255, 255, 255, zero is 24, right? 8, 16, 24. But now I'm going to add one more. So the CIDR notation for this would actually be 25. And if I put another one, the CIDR notation would be slash 26, 27. Remember, this is the fourth octet that we're working in right here. And that's all there is to building this chart, with one exception. And I'm going to put this back in editing mode in order to do this. I am going to delete this row here. I'll tell you why in a moment. I'm going to delete that row because I can easily calculate that in my head. And it's a lot of work to write this thing out every time. I can easily go 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, 256. I just start with 2, right? If I put a 1 in this position, I can make 2 subnets. If I put a 2 in this position, I can make 4 subnets, right? So I just go 2, 4. Another interesting thing here is, remember that how many hosts can I get if I can't use this? If this is network addresses, and so I have a 64, so I had a 1 here, 1 here, 1 here, 1 here, 1 here, 1 here, 1 here from in the address, whatever my IP address is. Well, 64 plus 32 plus 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1 actually equals 127. We're very close to this number here, 128. It actually turns out that I can get 0 through 127 actually turns out to be 128, right? There are 128 possible numbers. But remember, 2 of these I can't use. I can only get 126 possible hosts out of this network here. So I can get 0 through 127, which is 128 addresses, minus 2, 126. So besides being the value, this actually also can represent the number of hosts that I could get. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. Could also represent the number of hosts that I could get if I borrow at this point, except I have to subtract 2 from it. In the next video, we're actually going to take a problem and see how this chart works. One more thing, of course, when I do that, I'm not going to have this in here. I'm going to go ahead and delete that row because this row, let's just delete that. This row was just to show you that we're in the fourth octet. So this is my final chart here. As long as I'm in the fourth octet, this chart will tell me the value or the hosts that I can get out of borrowing these bits, and also the subnet math, or excuse me, the number of subnets is understood. 2 if I borrow this one, 4 if I borrow from this one, 8, 16, 32, 64, and so on, starting with 2 over here. All right, when I get to the next video, we'll take a problem and see how easily this works. This is going to blow you away how easy it is to use this chart. The only reason I told you everything I just did, I know it might be confusing to you, was in order to be able to build this chart. Once we've got this chart, from here on it's going to be easy sailing. So join me in the next video and we'll take a problem and see how easily we can do that problem here.